Hey, what's up, guys? It's Console, and today's episode 21 of Console Plays Minecraft. And actually, I've uploaded episode pretty much throughout the week. The main reason why I don't know why I've been having this problem. It feels like I try to do an episode, and I work on the episode. I try to work on something throughout the episode, and it doesn't. When I look at the episode, it just doesn't feel right. Like, I can easily just go ahead and upload these episodes, but it's like, I feel like what I'm doing in episode is not enough, and there's things like that when I'm just trying to work on certain things, and I just don't upload it. I don't know, it just feels like it's really, really not enough in the episode, but, after trying to record about 3 or 4 episodes this week, I kind of decided to take a break throughout the week, just work on the iron trench over there. And I've been having troubles with the iron trench. I believe I know what the problem is with it, and I need to go ahead and do something with that. It's just a matter of what chunks are loaded and what chunks aren't. But yeah, that's pretty much it. So I just kind of took the time to, you know, listen to a lot of music this week. I've been listening to people's new albums, going back and listening to some old stuff that I kind of missed out on. I think I got. Like, I don't know if you guys should listen to music that much, or that music in particular, but I went back and got MF Doom's Mad Villainy. Actually, that's him and Madlib's album. Just old stuff like that, as well as, yeah, that's pretty much what I was doing all week. I was just listening to music and stuff. Anyway, but yeah, this is the iron trench that I built, and as you can see, it's not working. Right now, it's not. This is here is built in the spawn chunks, and I didn't really think about building that is over here that has to go with it. That's a secondary village area for this. I believe how it works is when you set up the iron trench, when it goes to its rebuilding process, it will it'll detect a village here and then over there, and it keeps going back and forth. And it creates all 32 villages. So, if I have the mod on here, I can show you better. But it'll be like, you can see each one of these doors connects to the doors they're inside of here. And it creates a village. And that's why it's supposed to work very fast. I believe it spawns golems about every 10 seconds. And the reason why this isn't working too well is because this here is built completely in the spawn chunks. And that is not, surprisingly. Well, I thought it would be, but it's not. So, and I checked that because I pretty much just ran around this whole area dropping blocks down, and then I ran straight along this little dirt line here, dropping down blocks. I also went on top of the platform, and then I went to a desert biome all the way on the other side of the world. All the blocks along this area, and then partially here, despawned, but all the blocks up here didn't. But I actually looked it up, and there should be a way to make chunks stay loaded with hoppers. I don't know if it works anymore. As opposed to when you're using hoppers, it's supposed to keep moving the block back and forth, so it keeps the chunk loaded in order to do that. So hopefully that does work. So I'm going to try doing that along the chunk lines of that area, and maybe I can get the iron golem farm to work. But if you guys want to see how it's supposed to work, we can look at it in here. Anyway, this is TangleTech's. This is the whole creative world that he used to build the iron golem farm. And I also downloaded it to make sure, hey, you know, I can go back and forth and get more of a first-person visual of things that I don't understand when watching a tutorial. Maybe I may have to do a redstone or things like that. And all the redstone is set up right. Everything's pretty much set up right. The only thing that doesn't happen, as you can see here, there's actually pistons behind these blocks here and here. But when this side is extended, as well as the bottom, over here in this world, the bottom extends as well as this side. But in my world, the top never extends by itself. I don't know why it doesn't extend, but hey. I pretty much checked out a redstone. I didn't do any faulty redstone on it. So I don't know why it doesn't work the way it's supposed to. I probably could have missed something. I'm going to go back and watch this tutorial. Maybe tonight or tomorrow. Well, technically for me, I'll probably upload this tomorrow because it's Saturday, so I don't know if I want to upload this late, depending on how much I can do in this episode, but yeah. But, iron golems are constantly spawning in here, as you can see. Let's see. A few of them just spawned. Let's give it a little bit of time. And a few more should spawn, or one or two more should spawn. Oh, there it goes. And as soon as that one spawns, yeah, as it just works pretty fast. I'm having problems when trying to build this though. My first problem is, in order to get the appropriate amount of villagers in here, you pretty much, well, he pretty much, I think zombies allowed. Hold up. All right, so he pretty much put two villagers in here, and he did something where he put the villager on the roof and broke a few blocks on the roof in order to create a village. And it's supposed to cause villagers to breed in order to make more. The problem with that is what I did it in my world, it pretty much bred villagers, all right? And a lot of villagers get, when they breed, they kind of get pushed through the blocks. So I tried using full blocks, they kept getting pushed to their blocks, and I eventually got the appropriate amount of villagers in here. I put the lava and everything back, but the villagers were a very big pain. I think the villagers were the biggest pain of this whole project. So, yeah. And the rest on the roof here is all. I think I actually messed up on something on the roof before, but I got it all working all right. Yeah, I don't know why it doesn't work that well. I'm gonna have to go back. As I said, I'm gonna go back and check it out. And after doing a few things that I think I may have to do, if that still doesn't work, then I'm not really sure. Anyway, let's go ahead and head back to our LP world. All right, we're back here. Anyway, something I was, well, I had started working on. I was trying to do a video before, and I scrapped it. As you can see, I cleared out the villages and stuff in this area. Well, that's not really any villages, they're just small houses. But I'm pretty much flattening out this whole area from all the way over here to the desert. There's actually a desert biome over there. I don't know if you guys know that. And my world is having trouble loading since I guess I'm recording. There it goes. Maybe if I F3. I just have to wait for it to load. But yeah, there's a village on the other side of the world, and I'm pretty much flattening out this whole area, going straight towards the village. The reason why is I'm re-terraforming it. I want to turn this whole place into more of a jungle biome. It won't actually turn into a jungle biome because it's still a forest, but just replace it with jungle trees. Is I personally like the way the jungle trees look a lot better. I would like to do some buildings up in the jungle trees, and I pretty much think that all these farms and things I want to build will look better, which I kind of like the jungle trees just hovering around them. So yeah. This here is the sugarcane farm I started working on, and it's pretty much built. Each one of these are built within a chunk, and I only built four right now. But I want to, I don't know how many I'm actually going to build. I want to be able to get a massive amount of sugarcane in order to do villager trading because I still have the villager purifier down here. And yeah, it's pretty much all it's for, I guess. I don't even know you can really do much with sugarcane. That's just one of the things where it's like if you're not making paper, you don't really need sugar for much, then yeah. And I also need to build a tree farm because I ran out of a lot of material when trying to build the iron trench, so I need a tree farm eventually. I think I'm just gonna build a tree farm, use some hoppers in order to collect these saplings and such. And I need to actually probably need to do some caving because my redstone supply is very low. Let's go ahead and head to our storage room and I can show you guys pretty much what I use when building the iron trench. I know I used about four chests of cobblestone in order to make stone to build it. I primarily use stone and stone brick for it. I used a lot of material in order to make pistons. Let's get in here. But yeah, my redstone supply is low. This may look like a lot to you guys, but with the amount of redstone blocks I had before, that can fill up about three of these chests almost. No wood, no wood, nope. A little bit of wood, no wood. All these used to be almost filled with cobblestone. Oh, yeah. And what else did I use? Iron is good because I do have the iron chain set up. It does work a little bit, but it's not fast like it's supposed to. But yeah, it just took a lot of material, but I can easily replace those things, so I'm not really worried about that. So we can start doing that today. So I think the first thing I need to do is actually finish the sugarcane farm. I'm gonna go up here and sleep though, because the new zombies. I said an Enderman. The new zombies and these snapshots are no joke. Like, they can track you from like anywhere, and it's extremely annoying. Not to mention they spawn almost anywhere as well. Do, 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 do. It's morning. All right. But the sugarcane farm that I built, it's just really simple, I guess. I think this is one of the best ways you can build one farm, unless you want to build it with pistons and such. But it's just seeing the ground. It's a pumpkin lantern. I don't know what it's called. Water, lily pads, so you can walk on it, and if you break blocks, they fall on top of the lily pad and don't fall into the water. And there's this whole Minecraft myth. This has been out for like years now. I don't understand why people still believe in it, or why people even say it still exists. Well, they said if you grow sugarcane on top of sand, it grows faster. It does not grow faster at all. It's been proven to not grow faster, because people have actually did tests with redstone. It doesn't grow faster, people. I mean, in some instances, it looks better. But it really does not make a difference, because each sugarcane has its own time of growing. So, yeah. Don't believe everything you hear, people. People do that a lot in the world today. It's not true. But, yeah, let me go ahead and finish up the farm. I need to collect a lot more lily pads, as you can see, as well as I'm still growing pumpkins in this area down here. I'm going to probably make the automatic pumpkin farm. I saw a pumpkin farm that Zoomavoy made, a pumpkin tower. I'm not sure if I should do something like that, or actually set up like a Foliata one. I've actually been having troubles with frame rate in my world ever since I built the Iron Trench, as well as upgraded to the snapshots. So, I don't know if I really should build any more Foliata stuff, because it can really plummet my frame rate, I guess. But I think that tower would be pretty nice. Probably I'll build about 4 of them, because I want to have a lot of this stuff. So, actually, 2, 2, 2, and 2. 2 melon, 2 pumpkins beside each other. That sounds pretty cool. But yeah. Anyway, let me go ahead and get to work. Alright, so I've been doing a little bit more work with the sugarcane farm, as well as I set up 2 other farms here. Another thing I have to do, I have about half of this set up. I need to get some more pumpkins to put in these places here. As you can see, as the lighting comes up through the water, as well as the lily pad that you can walk on. And then fill that in, as well as more water and lily pads for that, and then this whole area here will be done. I probably will expand it out some more, depending on how much sugarcane I actually get from the harvest. So far, I get probably about anywhere up to here. A lot of sugarcane just from about half of this, so it's pretty decent. I've also set up these 2, these are automatic, not fully automatic, pumpkin farms, and we're going to be making it full automatic right now. So the idea I would like to do with this, I'm not sure if I already talked about this or not, because it's been a while since my last cut, but we're going to be setting up a hopper timer along with comparators and a redstone signal, and pretty much the signal will be turning off these torches. So, and I also want to have a storage room here in the center. So there's 2 of the pumpkin farms here, and there's going to be 2 melon farms here in these places. So we have this small area here in the center for storage and such. Actually, how wide is this? So I got to go 2 out on the east side. So let me just go ahead and grab some blocks just so I know exactly how much space I have for building purposes. Let's grab this. And get rid of... See, if it goes, if there's 1 in the middle, it goes out 2 on each side. Like, I think it's like this. So center, 1, 2, yeah. So we have this small area here in the center, and we can set up a small storage room here. I don't really need anything too big, I guess. Just because I'll be constantly coming to check on this to make sure everything is cool with it. So I think what I'm going to do is have the hoppers. I think the hopper is here. Let's get rid of these blocks. these hoppers here are going to be connected, and they're going to go towards the center, as well as on the other side. They go into the small area of chest, and we're going to be accessing the area from these sides. And we're going to have the redstone probably on the bottom to try to get up to both of these. I believe I'm going to have to do something. Like, if I set up a... I'm trying to do something without messing with the pistons. I'm probably going to play with something in creative mode, but let's go ahead and place our hoppers down. So, these sides are going to be covered. Where's the middle? Start here. This is the easiest way to find out the middle for me. Oops. Alright. Middle. It's here. I'm going to need the block here anyway. So all the hoppers are going to be connected going in this direction. As well as on this side. And then this hopper in the middle, I think I'm going to have the chest probably a little bit forward. So let's go a few blocks forward. Probably about here. So if I did the same thing on this side, oh, it's in the middle. 1, 2, 3. Let's go back to there. So that's where chests are going to be that the item's going to be collecting in. And we're going to have the chest. We're going to have a double chest, not just a small little chest there. I should have chests already made. I guess not. 1, 2, 3, 4 of us. And it's going to be like, once we get back over here. So like this. And we gotta do the same thing on this side. Oops. I'm gonna go ahead and change the blocks out under them as well. Once I decide what I'm going to do for the floor, I'm thinking about for the storage room, because of the items here, let's just mark this like so. I'm gonna enter the storage room from the sides, so the sides will be here. Maybe a 1x1 space so I can put up a door just to prevent mobs from the outside from getting in. Put that in the center. Alright, so I kind of got an idea what I'm going to do. Let me go ahead and try to get like a basic setup. And then we will be back in a moment. Alright, after playing around with this for a few minutes, I kind of got an idea of what I'm going to be doing. First off, this is what it looks like. We're going to have item frames on here. So that's going to be pumpkin. That's going to be melons. This here is where the entrance is going to be. So we're going to make that out of spruce wood. Like so. And we're going to have chest right here. So going up 3 or maybe 2. I don't know. With double chest, 1 trap chest, and 1 regular chest. Just to give the room a little bit of definition, I guess, or shape. So like that. We're going to have an iron door for the door, so a button is going to be on the outside. So we make the button stone, because we are using wood in a wall. Bow. And the inside is going to be a pressure plate. How you doing, spider? Surprised these zombies haven't gone aggro on us yet due to the new zombie AI. And for the floor, I'm thinking let's use wood, regular wood. And I'm actually not using slabs for once, just because I'm actually going to be doing some building under the floor. We're going to be doing the redstone wiring for the farms himself under the floor. Let me see. I swear, this shovel is pretty good, but it's just too much sometimes. Yeah, that zombie is going to aggro on us. Breaks blocks way too fast. Oh, Oh. Oh, that's probably the social zombie mechanic right there. There's a lot of zombies incoming. I swear, like... Alright, let's go ahead and sleep. But yeah, I'm pretty sure I've talked about this earlier, about the whole new zombie mechanics. Like, I understand Mojang is trying to get people more of a challenge in the game, but it's extremely annoying compared to being something that's kind of fun. Other people may think it's fun, but it really is just like, if I'm trying to work on something, I constantly have to go and sleep. And like, look at this. Look at all the zombies who just came out of nowhere, and they're still aggro on me. And also, it was a big problem when I was trying to build the Iron Golem farm. Zombies are just everywhere. So, alright, let's do fill this in. 2, 3. And here in the floor, where the chests are going to be, it's going to be spruce wood. That's also a great visual indicator when I'm under the... Well, I'm underground working on the wiring. And I'm thinking for a ceiling, I may use glass? I don't know. I kind of have a ceiling that is more open, I guess. Just so I'll be able to come in here and kind of look up and see these towers here. Because they actually look pretty cool. Looking at it from a distance and from here. Let's see. So we're going to have the chest in this area. We can go ahead and make a few chests. I want it to face this way. Have to make a lot more than that. And here. And I'm thinking let's have it go up 2 for now. I don't really know how much I'll actually be getting with this in the long run. I can easily just expand it out more if I start getting more items than I thought I would originally. Alright. And that's good. For now. We've got to fill in the rest of the floor here. So let me go ahead and finish up the floor. I think around the walls we're going to be, since it's like that, we can extend this here out. Yeah, that's, Problem is this area here. I don't really need to do anything nice here. Oh, that's pretty good. Yeah, let's leave it like this. Alright, so let me go ahead and fill the rest of this in, and next we're going to finally start working on the redstone for this, because I need to get a few more things in order to actually start working on it. Or I like to actually test it out in Creative World as well. Alright, so after playing in the Creative World for a little bit, trying to figure out a way to automate this, I figured out a very easy way, and then I ran across a problem. In order to automate. The torches are here on the side. I can easily automate these by placing more torches and having them go on the ground to do so. But there are torches that are right here on more of the inside. And that becomes more of a problem because there's actually a hopper right behind that stair. So either I could animate it, but I could automate it. But at the same time, it's just like, it's a lot of trouble, it feels like. Especially if it'll feel kind of off having, well, the way it'll be wired. I could rewire the whole system, but I really don't feel like doing that specifically tonight. But, actually, I couldn't rewire the system because it'd either be torches here or another side. So, yeah. I'm probably going to leave it how it is. But anyway, I think this episode is getting a pretty decent length. I wanted it to be pretty decent because I haven't uploaded in a few days. I'm going to go ahead and finish this room up right quick. And the room is almost finished. A few things I have to do. I have to add the other two farms over here for the melons. And then I want to decide after that what I want to do for a roof. Because I really would like to be able to look up and see all four of the structures where they'll be here. Because I think it'll look pretty cool. I really like the way this looks with the nether brick. But yeah, I don't know if this episode is very long or not. I was hoping it'll be very long, try to make up for me not uploading. So I apologize to those who are looking forward to your videos and not seeing them. Just kind of been in like a Minecraft type, I think it's like a rut, I don't know, when you try making things, but it just never feels right to you. So yeah, I also want to go ahead and say, I believe I said this already, but thank you guys for 800 subs. I think I just hit 800 subs a little while ago. I just want to see what this looks like from a distance, because I think it looks pretty good. But yeah, thank you guys for 800 subs. I'm working my way up. Hopefully, it'll be at about 1,000 by the end of the year. And, well, it's halfway through the year. Maybe around when school was supposed to start back up for people. Actually, this looks really nice from a distance. What am I gonna do? I think I might just leave that actually open. I was actually debating when I want to build anything up here. It won't be anything too serious. It's probably just be a lookout point so I can. It's gonna kind of curve around the mountain so I can see my whole area, what I do with it throughout time. But yeah, I'm probably gonna do some off-camera stuff. You know, get some jungle saplings to plant around here and so on. And that's pretty much gonna be it, guys. If you guys enjoy it, please leave a thumbs up rating. It really helps out. If you're brand new and you enjoyed the video, make sure you guys subscribe. And that's pretty much it. Later.